Question for Amy, between the fighter, American Hustle, this, are you drawn to real characters?
Well, I mean, it would appear so, but I think what it is that real women are drawn so beautifully. We're all so human, and so it's hard sometimes for writers to capture that, and I think we're still working on developing really human female roles that don't have an archetype that sort of defy, just typecasting, and so I think maybe, I actually hadn't thought about it until we're talking about it, but it is true. I feel that I've been lucky enough to play these women that, are vulnerable and strong, bold and shy. It's something that all women identify with, like we're human, women or men, we all have a lot of contradiction and a lot of depth to us, and I've just been lucky enough to get to tell their story. So
it's easy. I had agreed that I would paint 100 more paintings for him, because I thought if I'm painting, he won't have me knocked off. So also he agreed to pay me $100 for each one. And I thought I could live on that while I try to sell my paintings, the MDH paintings, and they got okay, so that's what I did.
This question is for Amy. I just was wondering, did you study painting to prepare for the role, and did Margaret teach you anything?
Yeah, I didn't. I my fiance is a painter. We paint a lot in my house, but I knew that in the time that I had, there was no way that I was going to be able to paint like Margaret. So it was important to me in going up and meeting Margaret was to watch her paint, because I find the relationship between an artist and the way they handle the canvas is so telling, and the way they handle whatever medium they choose to work in is so specific, and a very tactile person when I'm working on a character. So getting my hands on the brushes that Margaret used were so big for me. And so no, I can't paint like Margaret. But what Margaret has taught me is bigger than what you put on the canvas, and it's what you put into your life. And her coming out of this and saying that she had to forgive Walter, and forgiveness is something, and grace, and that is a huger lesson, a much huger lesson than painting for me.
Thank you.
Margaret, I know that the writer-producer Scott Alexander and Larry Karaszewski have been wooing you for a while, right? I mean, what did you want a movie about this story, or were you reluctant to give them the rights?
I was reluctant at first, and I turned down other offers because I didn't know what they would do with it in Hollywood. So when Scott and Larry came to me, they wanted to produce it and write it and direct it themselves and have total control of what, And after several times we met, and I trusted them, and they did a draft, and we went from that, and it took 11 years for it to actually happen.
I mean, there must have been times when you thought, oh, this is never going to be a movie.
I mean, no, it would look like it was going to start off and everything was going fine, and then something very unusual would happen and everything would be down to zero again. And so when Reese Witherspoon was going to play me, and then she found out she was 3 months pregnant right before the shooting, squelched that. I thought, well, this is it, never going to happen. But then Tim Burton came along, and everything really just went forward from then on.
Now, had you seen any Tim Burton movies? I mean, he bought art from you, right?
Yes, I knew him from before. He commissioned me to paint paintings for him, so, and I really liked him. I knew he would do a great job, but I didn't know it was going to be this great.